The next video will be right or left skewed distributions. It could also be positive or negatively skewed distributions. All right, so let's define right skewed distribution. That's defined as most of the data falls to the left of the mean. And what does that entail? Well, let's draw a right skewed distribution and talk about some of its properties. The first one is, let's draw a vertical line at the highest point, right? And this is going to be the mode, which will be small m. The next one will be, to the right of it, is going to be the median, capital M. And the next one over that will be the sample mean. So you can see that for a right skewed distribution, you have the mode, which is the highest point. The median is in the middle between the mode and the sample mean, and then you have the mean. Now, very quickly here, when I say that the mode is the highest, it doesn't mean the highest in terms of this axis, right? Sometimes we call it the x. It's not the highest on the x-axis. It's the highest in the y-axis, right? And so that is going to be very important to understand the difference. Another way, of course, that's the correct way of knowing if the distribution is right skewed. But sometimes if somebody gives you a picture, is it right skewed, left skewed, and how would you be able to determine that? That's not a problem. Just think of your hand squishing the right side. If your hand is squishing the right side of the graph, it's right skewed. But that's very, very non-mathematical. Again, the true way of determining if it's right skewed or not is to understand, of course, the axes, right, the x-axis, as being larger to the right, smaller to the left, and understanding that the mode is less than the median, which is less than the sample mean. That is the proper way of knowing if it's right skewed or not. All right, let's move on to the left skewed distribution, and that is most of the data falls to the right of the mean. And again, let's draw a distribution and look at some of its properties. And again, we know that if we draw the line at the most data, right, that would be the mode. And then on the left of it would be the median. And then we have X bar, which is the sample mean. And again, you noticed that the median is in the middle between the two. Okay, and so sometimes they give you a graph, right, and they want to know if it's left skewed or right skewed. Well, that's not a problem. Just think, hey, this is squished on the left side, right? So you took a hand and you squished it. That, of course, is not a math term or technical in math jargon, but if you can imagine your hand squishing one side of the graph, well, then it's left skewed. In this case, it's squashed over here on the left. But again, proper way is to understanding that, you know, you have a number line on the X, right? Smaller on the left, larger on the right. And if you take X bar, that's going to be smaller, right, than the median. And of course, smaller than the sample mean. The median is smaller than the sample mean. That, of course, is the proper way of understanding if the data is left skewed or not. Okay, so let's do some examples. So again, left skewed. It's very easy to draw a very basic left skewed, right? It's squished which way, left or right? That's right, left. So draw a hand on the left, and then do a couple of bars, right? Squish to the left. And think about this. The tallest bar is which one? That's right. The mode, right? And then, of course, the middle between any of these, left skewed, right skewed, the middle is what? Median, right? And then the other one must be X bar. And you know, on the X axis, from the left, it's smaller. All the way to the right, it's bigger. So X bar is less than capital M, all right, and less than small m. Sample mean is less than median, less than mode, right? And the next one is right skewed. And again, right skewed, where is it squished? On the left or on the right? It's squished on the right. So you draw a hand, right? And then you do a couple of bars, right? Which is the tallest bar is what? Mean, median, mode. That's right, mode. Then the median, because it's the middle between the two, and you have X bar, which is the sample mean. And you know, again, you know that it goes from left to right, right? This is small, this is bigger, right? Or larger, right? So what do we got? We got mode is less than median, is less than X bar. If you can keep that in your mind, put it on your sheet right before you take your exam or your quiz, you'll be fine, because any problem that comes up, you'll be able to do. So let's do some examples now. Here's the first one. Let's say the mode is 4 and the median is 8 and the sample mean is 3. So we want to know if it's left skewed, right skewed, or neither. It could be neither. All right. So let's find out. The first thing we want to do is we want to put the numbers in order from small to big. 3 is a small one. And we're going to put them in order, and we're also going to put an inequality to it. And it's going to be less than 4. This is the next number. Less than what? What's the next number? 8. Right? And we're putting it in with inequalities because these are the things we need to understand that gives us the property of left skewed, right skewed, and we're going to compare that with our problem here. So we got 3, 4, and 8, right, in order, and they all, 3 is less than 4, less than 8, so that's good. All right, so 3 represents what letter, or what central tendency, which is what the sample mean. And it's 4 represents the mode, and 8 represents the median. Now, question is, does this match with right or left skewed? No, it doesn't. And I could have told you already by the second one, the second term here, which is the mode. You notice that in left skewed and right skewed, the median is in the middle. So automatically, there was no median in the middle. So in this case, it's going to be neither. It's going to be neither or neither. Neither left skewed or right skewed. All right. We got the mean is 2, the median is 4, and the mode is 5. So let's put them in order. 2 is less than 4, less than 5, right? And 2 represents what? Well, that's the mean. That's less than the median, right? And 5 represents the mode. Well, that looks pretty good. We got the median in the middle, so that's good. Now we have to match. Is it right skewed or left skewed? Well, let's see. This one matches with that one pretty good, right? Because we got the mean, the median, and the mode. they all match. Perfect. So this one is going to be left skewed. All right. Let's try the next one. And that example is the median is 9. The mean is what? 10. And the mode is 3. Let's put them in order with the inequality. 3 represents the mode, and 9 represents the median, and the 10 represents the mean. That looks pretty good because the median is in the middle. That's one of the main requirements. Now the question is, does this match with any of these? And it does. It matches with this one. So this must be right skewed. So this is right skewed. All right, there is one more. There is one more example I want to show you. Well, maybe two more. The median is 9. The mode is 7. And the mean is 3. Let's do this. Let's put them in order. From smaller to large, 3 represents the mean. 7 represents the mode, and then the median. And again, the median is not in the middle. So we automatically know that this is not going to match with the left skewed or right skewed, so this is going to be neither. Or neither, right? So that's pretty easy. One more. This one, the median is 9, the mode is 9, and the mean is 9. Well, that doesn't look good. It doesn't match with the right skewed or the left skewed. So this one has a different property. They're all the same. What does that mean? Well, it means that it's symmetrical on 9. You probably have seen it as a bell curve, right? A normal. And because the mean, median, and mode are all the same, it's symmetrical distribution. That's a special case. And you should be able now to do left skewed, right skewed type problems, and also symmetrical distribution as well.